through that spot, I don't creep. Yeah, we ain't on none of that. Can't call it lucky, I give it my all every day of the week. You know what I'm on. I see a crowd at the bottom, ain't with that, I climb to the peak. Boy, straight to the top. Don't ride no red, but they know what I'm on, they address me as chief. I be dripping waters like a reef, slid off with a bag, but I ain't no thief. It's a sweet, they ain't even have a chance. I've been locked on that cash in a trance. Hit the end zone and do my little dance. Yeah, your chick blowing kisses like Lance. Should go tell your mans, it's a sweet.
What?
It's a sweet.
Yeah.
What? Acting like we ain't the ones, man, talk is cheap.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweet.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweet.
Get that boy out of there.
We ain't playing no games, we playing for keeps.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweep, do my dance, Mr. Clean. Game nice, but I play it so mean. Front line, I'm protecting the team. John Madden, yeah, I boom with the scheme. Dream chasing, I've been chasing the dream. Paper chasing, I just made it my thing. Got the bag, I just need me a ring. GMF, hold it down for the team. It's a sweep, right? Shout out to Jokic, I'm locked in. Man, I swear that I'm focused. Details up in the drip, I bet they didn't notice. Air Force Ones got me walking like POTUS. God's child, so I know that I'm chosen. Drake with me, man, I feel like DeRozan. Left and right wrist equally frozen. All four pockets equally swollen. It's a sweep.
What?
It's a sweep.
Yeah.
What? Acting like we ain't the ones, man. Talk is cheap.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweep.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweep.
Get that boy out of there.
We ain't playing no games, we playing for keeps.
Yeah.
It's bag season, I'ma post like a center. Diamond chains and a mink in the winter. All these rings on, you could tell I'm a winner. I'm a walking bucket like that boy out in Denver. Got the pink slip for these whips, ain't no rental. Steady breaking records, give them something to remember. Money, power, and respect is so simple. What separate good and great is they mental. It's a sweep.
What?
It's a sweep.
Yeah.
What? Acting like we ain't the ones, man, talk is cheap.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweep.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweep.
Get that boy out of there.
Hey, we ain't playing no games, we playing for keeps.
Yes, sir. It's a sweep. We the midweek. I tend to smile VVS on my teeth. Money made, rather I'll never be beat. Got rid of Brucko, got SOTG. Deep in that jungle, came out with a meat. Got a tread like got 2K on my feet. Slide with the bros, I don't care what you think. 17 flash, gonna go in a blink. Hey, hey. Wrist got no thirsty, like what do you drink? Last of the real, yeah, my kind be extinct. Bad little G used to drink from the sink. Whoa, whoa. No TLC, I'm too lit, we can't creep. Flight to Miami, I stay with that heat. Hopped on the jet, cause
it's a sweep.
What?
It's a sweep.
Yeah.
What? Acting like we ain't the ones, man, talk is cheap.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweep.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweep.
Get that boy out of there.
We ain't playing no games, we playing for keeps.
Yeah.
It's a sweep.
What?
It's a sweep.
Yeah.
What? Acting like we ain't the ones, man, talk is cheap.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweep.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweep.
Get that boy out of there.
We ain't playing no games, we playing for keeps.
Yeah.
Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin and slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me?
Yeah, told him I would be a boss before I had business. I don't even need nobody here to vouch. I was all alone, so I ain't have a witness. Right back to the lab. Gotta go to work, I'm revving up my engine. I was just putting groceries in the bag. Now wait a minute, yeah, forgot to mention. I'm $100 million richer. Might paint $100 million picture. One man army, but I don't fatigue. Better have $100 million coming with you. Got good karma, so I'm riding fiscal. Hit the crossover, leave them playing Twister. Or they thought that I was just a... Now when I do, they call me Mister. Stop it, big wall will suffice. Play with the family, playing with your life. Just got the ops hurt, looking sick. So we gon' disinfect them like a wipe. Had that boy a big cat with no stripes. Now on the gram, ain't worried about a light. Yeah, I had to go ahead and raise the fee. If you ain't rocking with it, take a hike.
Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin and slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Say you gon' ride. Is he gon' step by me? Can't do it back, keep racks on me. Name him with, I keep three on me. Oh, so you ride it. I can do everything that you gon' like. Young, rich, and famous, I'm living the life. Uh-oh.
I pull up in that new thing. I'm swerving and hogging up both lanes. You know I'm in the mood. After I score, I'ma bring it to you. They're a free agent, I give them the boo. I'm with the crew who we bringing it to. We got no limit, yeah, we on the ride. We all gon' step, we all gon' ride.
Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me?
Every time I'ma step with the steppers, black and white bins looking like pepper. Flawless diamonds, yeah, I'm good under pressure. 400 racks tucked in the dresser. Blowing money fast like Big Meech, thinking that they winning, big reach. They know I'm the best, I'm elite. I know when they hating is this
thing. Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me?
Top of that, she good for me. Made me wanna say.
And even though I got plenty, if I'm down to my last penny, I still got a. I know I got a.
I know I got a. Even when I'm down bad, yeah, I know how to bounce back. Cause you know I got a. And she look good, don't she? On top of that, she good for me. Made me wanna say. Even though I got plenty, if I'm down to my last penny, I still got a.
Earrings, they be shining, keep them blinded. Ain't met up, yeah, I can't. down just cause I took her on the island. The money keep on piling. Talk to me, yeah. Better talk nice. Fighting love with the fettuccine and bob that can't talk twice. Now they pray on my downfall. Everything I do, I gotta walk like. Let them in jacket off. What? Rich, so I'm so off life. God. Yeah. All these diamonds on me, go, just like Diego. God. Yeah. All these shooters on me, just go, just like Diego. God. Yeah. Got a dime piece with me, she gon' go, just like Diego. God. Yeah. They don't play with me, cause they know that I'm on go, no Diego.
Why you think we the same? We ain't the same. I'm the type to do the hitting up. You the type to pay hitters. Why you think we the same? We ain't the same. I'm the type to do the hitting up. You the type to pay hitters.
I can get it gone in a blink. Money. We can make a from the safe. Money. We can make a call if you tweet.
Money.
I can make a ball when I speak.
Money.
Brother used to hide a hundred. The hashback partner used to bust a couple scams off of Snapchat. Shorty tryna come up on the bands cause of that. We don't give a Uncle Sam if you ask that. Where the cash in the middle. Boy, I just solved the riddle for this pound cake. Giggles, now I see fiddle all around me. He little, my head was on a swivel. He was pushing a rental. Ain't it coincidental? He ain't really talking money. Who he talking to? Homie hopping.
We are just off the shores of Lake Erie in downtown Cleveland, Ohio, as we get set for football here at the always rocking Cleveland Browns Stadium. Today it's week 3 and we've got a good one in store as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Cleveland Browns. It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Here's second and 10. Thus far, it's not a start that's going to set the world on fire, but they've been pretty solid nonetheless.
And the first thing that crosses my mind, it certainly beats the alternative of starting 0-2. I do think that this is a team that's going to take a little time to find its footing. Hard to navigate the always tough NFL.
Second and 10.
Right offense, keep pushing the ball downfield.
Double 38.
Operating from the gun, Elliott. It's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I love those corners who can not only cover, but don't mind getting a little physical as well. How about the coverage on that play, knocking that pass away?
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Operating from the gun, Elliott. A complete to Drake London. And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. He missed on his first 3 passes, was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection, maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you wonder, can he get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. They think he might be off to the races. They suspected it was a power play up the middle coming at him, and boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
2nd down and 8. They run again with Horn. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. 8th play of the drive, 4th coming, and they need 8 yards on 3rd down. Off play action, Elliott. Eluding the pressure right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Adafe Owe able to finally wrestle him down for what's just going to be a huge loss. And it takes us to 4th down as well. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Fielded just inside the 30. A little juke. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Ravens will take over. Good starting field position for them here as they come up 1st and 10 at their own 37. Jackson. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. But you look at this Browns defense. They come into this one down at the 27th position in the league, Charles, against the run.
And this game for them is all about the line of scrimmage. Winning that battle, using their leverage, being the low man with power to take the offensive linemen and run them back into their own backfield and try and create some last yardage plays.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 10 yards there, good enough for a Raven 1st down.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Now they show jet sweep, but instead a run up the middle here. There he goes, left side. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Now a 1st down carry for Harris. Oh, he bowls over it. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another strong gain on the last 2 plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. So back-to-back big runs picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
From the red zone now, here's Jackson on 1st down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. So they'll get nothing out of that play, and it's 2nd down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Now a second and 10. They go play action with Jackson. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Browns are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line. Charles Nolan is out of the interception. It's run with Luke Willie knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points no matter what. At worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive?
And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. He may go. And all the way in. Touchdown.
Scouting report meeting, this was the explosiveness that they talked about trying to contain. They were concerned about it all week, yet he still did it to them. Wonder how that's going to carry over the rest of the game.
And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Second down and 6 now. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. His early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked off by Cody Joseph. And he returns it into enemy territory down the 35-yard line.
Well, certainly not giving much hope to their defense, are they? Because for the second time now, that D has had to run back out on the field early after an interception. And remember, on the last drive, the opposing side took it in for 6 after that interception.
On the carry, it's Hood. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Well, the first play of the drive lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on 2nd and 14. Off the play fake. Elliott. He'll let this go for the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down. Yeah, look at this Baltimore defense. This crew against the pass. Issues at times, ranked number 24, Charles, in the NFL.
They'll take that play right there each and every snap because throughout this season, they've given up some big plays. To be able to hold someone to no gain, oh, yeah, they'll take that one all game long.
And he comes back with one complete. And he'll go down the line before getting this inside the 30. Able to convert on 3rd and 14, a terrific play call.
And that's well executed there on 3rd down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw.
He has been tough to stop here this first half. Here's a 2nd and 8. Off play action. Elliott. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
That will throw here to his running back. Taken down, but not before they reach the 50. A gain there of 21 yards.
And they'll use him out of the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. Four catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Play action. Now Jackson. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Consecutive catches for him. That good for 11.
But they certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
Now here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
They go play action now. Jackson. And this is going to be tight end Andrews. Now he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down. Here's McGee. And here he'll get it down to the 7. From the 7, it's 2nd and 5. Now Jackson going to shift him around. Again, they'll run. This is McGee. They'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. A great play there. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Ravens have got it back to within a score. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now 13-7. So here comes the kickoff, and what now is just a one-score, six-point game. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Cleveland offense ready to go. Early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally, because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated, because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice, but at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Looking to throw, Elliott. Looking left side, and it's complete. extra point by Bass, up and good. And the lead now stands at 13. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And running with power here. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Right now, Charles, it just feels like they're trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time out, but they still trail by double digits here. We'll see if this offense is once again up to the task.
Yeah, and I think that after the last drive, they've gotten pretty revved up, don't you think? Everything they were doing was working pretty well. They go back out there with the same mindset, play at the same tempo and the same pace. Still a lot of time left to make something happen in this one.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Now it's Jackson. Looking for his man on the out route, he's got Diggs. First target, first catch, and a first down. Play action. It's Jackson. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And they'll get to him after a gain of seven to the 47. Again, Jackson. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. Throwing is Jackson. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. A great effort there. 47 yards. And the Ravens are back within a score. Oh, such great concentration there, going right up against the side of the end zone, but able to get the feet in bounds.
There are so many things that go into that catch, and you just mentioned the concentration, being able to catch the football, get your feet down in bounds, hang on to it all the way through the process of the catch. That was a phenomenal play.
Point after, right down the middle, and the lead will shrink to six. Here's the kick unit now for the Ravens as they'll send this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Look at the right sideline, that's complete. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. They have 34 yards there.
Well, you don't have to be a genius to watch this game and figure out they've had plenty of success moving the football here in the first half.
We've seen exhibits A, B, C, and right on down the line, haven't we?
Yeah, we just saw exhibit Z right there.
On first and 10, Elliott looking middle, and it's incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
Now Hood. Point by Bass, up and good, and the lead now stands at 13. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. Well, not much time remains here in this first half. We'll see if they can get something out of this drive, at least a field goal. They could certainly use it. Down by two scores. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
I'm not quite sure what he thought he saw there, but the reality was certainly a much different picture than what he anticipated. And give credit to the defense. They were down on the flash when he broke out of there, and it forced him out with almost nothing to show for his efforts.
Takes us just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 75 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
On first and 10, it's Jackson. Under pressure, and down he goes. The second back of the 36. Ravens going to use the third and final timeout as they stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Now it's Jackson. And this is caught inside the 5. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Still all sorts of time left in this game, and you'd like to be able to...
Now, I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Jackson now. And all that will be intercepted.
Picked off by Greg Newsom. The defense will gear up to start the run, but having some troubles, they were ready for the pass, too.
Yeah, they were able to make a catch up with him crashing and playing the run, but that was a very ill-advised throw right there. The opportunity lost.
On first down, Elliott. Oh, he's got that wide open, complete. And they're going to get this all the way out past the 20. Now a timeout signal for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Now a play fake here on first down.
That one deep for London.
And that's caught inside the 30. And he's going to be pushed out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. And that will get a late timeout.
comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. The kickball pass is good, and that will do it for this first half. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. The Ravens set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
By no means certainly are they out of this contest. Two-score game, start of the third quarter. But you feel like if they don't get points and then they give up points, then it can become a slippery slope. This feels like an important possession.
Yeah, that slope becomes even more slick if you come away empty-handed on this drive, because then you give them a chance to extend their lead. You need some kind of points here, even if it's just a field goal. It's what I call one of those calming drives, try and slow things down a little bit.
Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. To the flat, that's complete to his running back. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. From the gun, it's Jackson. And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. Absolutely not. Trying to start the second half off on the right foot. Unfortunately, going to give the ball up. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today.
Picked off by Greg Newsom. And the Browns are in great shape here as they take over. 46-yard line.
The Cleveland offense ready to go.
They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10.
They will be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 148 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Throwing on first down, Elliott.
Like a jumbo set with three tight ends here for first and goal.
Well, they go with a tight end carry, and he's in. Touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Browns take the interception on defense and convert it into 6 points.
An extra point by Bass, up and good,
and that pushes the lead up to 23.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Hang it home, boys. We got this.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
Here's Jackson to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
But what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front. The front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Look at this. Middle of the field. A breakaway. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
They'll throw on first down with Jackson. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 12 more yards there and another first down. Now Jackson. And my goodness, another interception. And the Browns will take over here just shy of the 30. I think you and I were a little surprised back in the game when he threw a second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now 5 times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. After the interception, here's Jackson. It's complete to Davis. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Now Jackson on first down. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Jamal Adams.
Yo, god damn, bro. What the fuck? This nigga throwing nothing but picks.
In this two-game stretch, and we're not done here.
It's almost as if they can't even believe their eyes. Or maybe, partner, is the confidence level in him so high that they believe he'll get out of it and make plays for them to win a game?
Well, they've said they believe in him. That's being tested right here. Here's 2nd and 7. Back to throw. Elliott. Over the middle, it's complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. And they're going to speed things up here. They run here with Hood. And space tough to come by there as he'll get maybe a yard to the 37.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Final minute now of the 3rd quarter.
Fight, 97. Fight, white. Green jack.
Off the play fake. Elliott. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's 3rd down. Looking to throw. Elliott. We're in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 3rd and 19, no problem, as they're able to convert. 3 quarters in the books. So in Raven territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 47. This is Hood on the ground. 159 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. And I think we can get used to seeing more of that in this 4th quarter, especially if they're having success on the ground like they did there.
Yeah, I think back when we met with the head coach in preseason, and all he talked about was building a bullet. And I think it was this situation he was envisioning. Trying to ice a game, plenty of time left, but being able to give the ball to his big runner, pound away, and try to finish off the game.
What a throw right there for the 1st down. He has taken some real punishment in this game, but still standing in the pocket completing that one.
He's a flat-out warrior. There's no question about that. How about him stepping up into the teeth of the rush and delivering there for that big strike and that big pickup.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Off play action, Elliott. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down. Well, fourth quarter with a 3-score lead here, Charles, but they're still going back to the air and looking for more points.
Well, with this game well in hand, it's an opportunity for the guys to come off the bench and get a chance to play. And a lot of coaches, they want to run their full playbook no matter who's on the field.
Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. The kick by Bass is good, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, ultimately, not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the three, and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. In trouble, and he's taken down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sand.
Well, at least it wasn't a turnover like the last drive. You'd think they'd make an adjustment and be ready to make up for that turnover. Instead, just another big play for the defense on that snap.
Looking to throw on second down. Walton. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they're able to bring him down at the 20. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Throwing on third and long. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. On first and 10, Walton. That's into the hands of Flowers over the middle. Second and 6. Not liking the look. They'll change the play.
Second and 6 at the 43-yard line.
Again, he'll drop to throw. But looking deep here for Flowers. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Cody Joseph. That's not one that he's going to want to remember, but he had to get it out of the way at some point in his first career interception.
And if he's the guy that they think he is, he's not laughing it off, but he's also not going to let it affect him as the game proceeds. He's going to go back out there, still be the same confident kid, the reason that they drafted him, and go out and play.
The Browns' drive about to get started. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. And they'll get him down up past the 15-yard line. They were looking for a cushion from that end zone. He gave it to them, 15 big yards.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Off the play fake, Elliott. He's got him in, complete. And finally, down at the 36-yard line. A big play that time for Cleveland. 48 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. And now we've got flags down. Looked like one of the Browns might have moved.
Watch the sink.
The full start backs him up 5, first and 15. Operating from the gun, Elliott. And that'll be incomplete. The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up,
You can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. But he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. The Browns on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. Now a timeout coming in here defensively as they stop it before the 2-minute warning with 2:09 to go in the game. They'll come to the line needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Back to throw again. And they'll catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up fourth down. So Tyler Bass on now for the field goal. Spotted at the left hash, this from 45. The kick by Bass is good, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, the only silver lining on the other sideline, CD, is that they kept him out of the end zone, but still, that's another 3 points added on to this large lead.
Yeah, no shortage of scoring or big plays on defense in this one. And even up by 4 possessions, still finding ways to create opportunities and capitalize with points.
And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their 3rd straight. And got his man, complete! And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. Now they got to get to the line quickly. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. From the gun. Walton. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Operating from the gun. Walton. And looking for Andrews, but this is intercepted. And the Browns are going to take possession here at the 37-yard line. The Browns in victory formation now as they take the knee.
Good guy.
So he'll take a knee here to wrap this one up, but he's going to want to keep that game ball. He was sensational. So with that knee, 3 weeks in the books, and they creep above 500 now at 2-1.
You know, I played with a guy once after taking a knee at the end of the game, and he came in and grabbed the equipment manager and said, make sure you watch that spot, you know, special, because I just took a knee for a win. That tells you how much guys enjoy that, because getting a win, no one takes it for granted.
Charles, a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends, and understandably so. Not only did they...